Hi, Helena and Elijah. Aunt Elisa here with a special birthday edition, as you can see, of Make Room for Elisa. And the reason I'm sending you a special birthday edition is because out of everything I've ever received, any gift in my whole life, the two of you are two of the most special gifts in my life that I've ever received. So here we go. If you remember where we left off, Elisa had just returned some mail to her upstairs neighbor, Mrs. Mitchell, who told her that she was going to be moving away. And she was wondering if Elisa could come visit her sometime. So let's see where the story takes us. Back downstairs, Elisa repeated their neighbor's invitation. Mrs. Mitchell said we can come and visit her after she moves, she told her mother. Moves? Is she moving? Mrs. Michaels sounded very surprised. Elisa nodded. She is moving to Connecticut. I didn't know that, said Mrs. Michaels. She rushed over to the telephone and began dialing a number. Elisa went to get her crayons. She decided she would make a picture for Russell. Then he would know she was sorry that Airmail had borrowed his Cub Scout scarf. Elisa made three drawings while her mother talked excitedly on the phone. As soon as she hung up from one call, she made another. Elisa wondered what all the excitement was about. That evening, when the family was eating supper, Mrs. Michaels made an announcement. I have a surprise for you, she told Russell and Elisa. Chocolate ice cream for dessert? Asked Russell eagerly. No, said Mrs. Michaels. I knew that, said Elisa, because I went shopping with Mommy this afternoon, and I know we didn't buy any chocolate ice cream. We bought strawberries, she told Russell. Aw, that's not so special, said Russell. This surprise isn't something to eat, said Mrs. Michaels. It's something much bigger and much better. It's a present? Asked Russell. What is it? He wanted to know. For some time now, your father and I have thought this apartment was too small for us. So we're going to move, said Mrs. Michaels. Move? I don't want to move, protested Russell. I like it here. This is my home. I don't want to move either. Elisa began to cry. Why can't we stay? If we move, I'll miss my friends and my Cub Scouts and everything, Russell complained. Mr. Michaels got up from the table and began to clear the dishes away. We are going to move and not move, he said, so you don't have to get upset about anything. How can we move and not move? Asked Russell. This was not a time for jokes and riddles. Moving was serious business, and he didn't like it one bit. We are moving to a bigger apartment in this same building, said Mrs. Michaels. It's on the fourth floor. We'll have more room, but our address will remain the same. Are we moving to apartment 4H? Asked Elisa. She wiped her eyes with her napkin. Yes, said her mother. How did you know? Asked Russell. He turned to look at his sister. Elisa discovered that the Mitchells are moving to Connecticut, and since their apartment is much larger than this one, it is just the perfect solution, said Mr. Michaels. You'll still be attending the same school with your same friends, said Mrs. Michaels. And now, Russell, you will have your own bedroom and all the privacy you want. So we're not moving, announced Russell with relief. We aren't and we are, said his father. Elisa took a drink of her milk and thought about what her father had said. We aren't and we are, she repeated, smiling. It was like a joke. And there's another surprise for you both, too, said Mrs. Michaels. "Another one?" gasped Russell. This was getting to be too much. "Is this one chocolate ice cream?" "It's a baby," said Mrs. Michaels quickly. "We're going to have a baby." "We are?" asked Elisa, amazed. "Another one?" asked Russell. "Elisa's our baby. How come we're getting another one?"
"Elisa is not a baby any longer," said Mrs. Michaels. "She is getting bigger every day. And in the fall, she will no longer be in nursery school. She'll be in kindergarten."
"I'm getting a teeny tiny bit bigger every day," Elisa announced.
"And so are you," she told Russell.
"And so is our baby," said Mr. Michaels.
"How do you know? Did you know about the surprise already?" asked Elisa.
"Yes, I did," her father admitted.
"When is the baby coming?" Russell wanted to know.
"In October, after the new school year begins," said Mrs. Michaels.
"And I think October is a great month for a birthday."
Well, that's all the time I have for this special birthday edition of Make Room for Elisa. But thank you guys for the nice birthday greetings this morning, and I love and miss you very much. See you soon. Bye.